I've been staying away from too much doom and gloom as far as catastrophic events and like that because I've been focusing on truth, which is all important. We know that events in this world are actually an attempt to give evidence and try to prove that we are not free to choose what we want to experience. Therefore, our will is greater than God. Somehow we've imprisoned ourselves because we want events to happen which we can point to and say, there's no way that we could have chosen this to happen. It can't be our choice. We're not free, you see. There's some greater will that's forcing things upon us we don't want, which means that since God created us free and now we say we're not free, it means there's some power greater than God's, which is actually we're hoping it's our will to be greater than God so we can create a separate creation and be prime creator, greater than God. This is what's going on in the world. This is one way to look at it. So stuff does happen here in this world that we don't like at all. And the funny thing is, a lot of people blame it on God. Say, God is doing this to us. As if God could do anything to us, creating us perfectly free to choose our experiencing. Whatever happens is what we're choosing to experience. Not, God's not forcing some experience on us. That's interesting. So, last couple weeks, I have been frantically preparing for some sort of catastrophe, actually. I had a dream that showed me something, earthquake, something shaking at least, here in the Bay Area. The Bay Area was shaking. But there's some other facets to it that I couldn't quite figure out. And the preparations are very intense for something quite massive, quite bad. And I said, maybe it's the Hayward Fault, because I saw it was shaking in that area. But I said, how could the Hayward Fault cause anything that bad? Anyway, the preparations have gone on intensely, and I'm feeling there's something very potent coming. I said, what in the world could it be? And I'm really not paying much attention to doom. I'm trying to work on that. Happiness is uncaused. Truly, it is uncaused. Therefore, since it's uncaused, it can't be undone, right? What is uncaused cannot be undone. There's no way to undo it. But I keep on preparing and preparing and preparing. I need this, I need this, I need this. I need to keep working on it. I feel like pressure is to be ready by this weekend. That's what I've been told. Be ready by this weekend. So why this weekend? Why the 24th? Be ready by the 24th. What's that? I think that's Saturday. Well, the Pope is visiting the Holy Land on Saturday. So, there are others who are saying the 20 this weekend is something very important for some reason. So it just so happens I was told to be ready by this weekend in all these extensive preparations. Stuff like respirators, good respirators, and gas, electricity, things not working, but oh, there's more to it. There's more to this than just an earthquake in the Bay Area. That's why I'm saying, well, what's going on here? So I'd start digging into it tonight and saying, does anybody else feel that this weekend is there may be something happened this weekend, really quite catastrophic? And lo and behold, I found something, and it's pretty amazing. It could potentially account for preparing intensely for some sort of sustained event. Feel like there's gonna be a lot of dust, a lot of dust, a lot of problems with crops and food. I mean, this is something nasty coming. It's possible, possible. at some level, some dimension, something is going to happen. I don't know if it's going to happen in this timeline or whatever. Something happened yesterday that was a real attention getter. We were watching the baseball game, the Giants game. They're playing the Colorado Rockies. And this relief pitcher, Santiago Casilla, was left in the game in the ninth inning to hit. He usually doesn't hit at all. And he can't hit at all. He just doesn't know what he's doing at the plate. And so everybody laughs and jokes him in the dugout and they, come on, you can do it, get a hit, you know. It's like a big comedy when he gets a rare chance to hit. So what did he do? He actually made contact and hit a quick ground ball to the second baseman. The second baseman has it, and I say, okay. And then lo and behold, Santiago Casilla is sprinting towards first base like his life depended on it. I say, well, what's he doing? And he goes faster and faster, like he's having to try to catch his breath or something, like his life is in front of him. He's got to get it. I said, wow, this is weird. And you know, he's thrown out by easily thrown out. And I said, what's he doing? You know. And so he suddenly, just before he hits the bag, he like something weird happens, and then he falls down across the bag, first base. And face first in the dirt. And then he starts pounding his hands on the dirt like this. And he's like, wow. I thought he had tripped and fallen. You know, it was just making a clowning around. And then he rolled over and back, and he was just like in terrible pain. And pounding the dirt and the ground and writhing all around. I've never seen anything like it on a baseball field. He was just... went on and on and on and on. My God, it was scary. And it caught everyone's attention. It's like, wow, they've never seen anything quite like this on a baseball field. What? It like went down like it was shot. And it was a pulled hamstring. But the way it played out was like really weird. And it just got everyone's attention. We're talking about it. It's like, what's he doing? Well, wow, why? Okay, so I'm reminded of Santiago Casilla tonight as I'm reading this information about a potential meteor strike off the west coast of Puerto Rico on May 24th. Apparently someone from Puerto Rico was a contactee of UFOs, and he was shown a movie of the projection of the future. Okay, now I'm familiar with this. I was shown a projection of the future back in, was it, 1997, early 98 time frame, and shown what's going to happen in the future. So he relates this, and he's very credible, actually, a very credible person. He took a picture of the UFO that he had been on, apparently, and with a fighter jet chasing it. And the whole thing is rather credible, actually, compared to most, you know. It's very credible. I tend to believe that he had some experience, for sure. And he says he was shown this event, actually, that's going to take place. There's a meteor coming in. I don't know how big it is, but maybe two-thirds of a mile across. It's a fairly large meteor. It's not an extinction-level event, the size-wise. But anyway, I happen to believe that, I've said in other videos, space rocks are going to come in and cause problems. They're going to hit the ocean. They're going to hit, you know, cause tsunamis. They're going to cause dust clouds, vapor clouds, and all this. That's what I've been shown. I don't know exactly where and when, but he said that he was shown May 24th. Somehow he was shown the date and with the location of this. And there are others, too, who have had dreams of something happening at this meteor shower. Now, they're telling us about this meteor shower this weekend. Very unprecedented kind of thing. Very rare, super strong meteor shower happening this weekend. And it's like, you know, I wonder if there's a rock along with those meteors, a large one, you know. So, now, he said that it's going to strike the ocean And it's also going to hit the ocean floor so hard it's going to trigger a massive earthquake, like a 12.0, just an incredibly strong earthquake. Now I just wonder if that super strong earthquake couldn't resonate the planet in such a way that it might trigger other earthquakes. It might trigger the Hayward Fault, for instance. You know, you could have an earthquake here, or you could even feel this earthquake all the way across the country. I don't know. He also said huge, huge tsunami going to Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, East Gulf Coast, East Coast of USA, etc. Now, it just happens that Santiago Casillas from the Dominican Republic, and you know, what happened to him is just suddenly coming down, going, falling like a shot and smashing into the ground and then pounding the ground like this. And then in such incredible pain and suffering, you know, I wonder if it had some sort of foreshadowing of what may happen to the Caribbean area, Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico. Now, they say that FEMA has brought in so many coffins and body bags over the last year to Puerto Rico. They say they're expecting a huge disaster there. So, you know, and apparently there's a lot of corroboration about this. So, what to make of it? What to make of it? It would account for a lot. It would account for a lot. It would count for the type of preparation I've been told to look towards. You know, it's just sort of a long-term sort of situation that we may need food long-term. That sort of a global issue is coming. It would certainly cause a lot of disruption, wouldn't it? Now, if you live on the East Coast, you might want to be somewhere else this weekend. That's very possible. Not a bad idea, actually. We certainly live in the times where these things are foretold to happen. So it wouldn't be surprising at all. Again, I'm very frantic. Be ready by this weekend. You gotta have your everything sort of set up by this weekend. Very important. So it just happens to exactly correlate with this prophecy of May 24th. This meteor is going to strike, and lo and behold, there's this huge meteor shower happening right then. I didn't know any of this stuff. Didn't know about it. When I began preparing and felt there's going to be some trouble late May, I said, you know, something. And also I was told I'm going to maybe go somewhere late May, get out of this area, you know, just something's going to happen late May. This is what I've been told. So it also fits with the dream I had several years ago, this massive stones coming into the world, just causing this incredible amount of dust everywhere, and I was fleeing it. I was fleeing this in a white vehicle, and I managed to escape it. So it's possible. There's a possibility of something happening. Again, it's not punishment. God doesn't punish us at all. How could God punish us for exercising our freedom? We're free to try to imprison ourselves, for sure. God's not punishing us for anything. God is not a punisher. God is love. God is not a punisher. God doesn't get angry. That doesn't wreak, you know, rain disaster down on us. Not in the slightest bit. However, we do rain disaster down upon ourselves to try to prove that we couldn't possibly be free. Otherwise, we wouldn't be suffering from this, see? I'm not the only one preparing for this date either. There are others that have got this feeling like we need to prepare right now, for something. Something's coming. So it might be this meteor. It fits. This guy's account of his close encounter, it sounds, having studied this my whole life, it sounds very legitimate. Very legitimate. Very credible. The photographs have been checked out, and they seem to be very credible. So at least somebody feels there's, you know, trouble coming. Yeah. So again, maybe the East Coast of the U.S. isn't the best place in the world to be this weekend. Maybe a little higher, you know, higher ground, go to the Catskills or something like that. Or go to the Appalachians. don't hang out in Miami maybe this weekend. That might be not the, but again, who knows as to timing. It's just, I'm just giving a heads up because definitely I have this feeling I need to be prepared for some sort of, you know, major disaster by the 24th, by this weekend, May 24th, 25th. And it is odd that the Pope is visiting, you know, going to visit Israel, the Holy Land, and seems to be quite an important situation that's going on in the world right now. Just keep in mind that happiness is uncaused. It's uncaused. Freedom is uncaused. It simply is. It simply is. We don't have to. We're trying to figure out how it's caused so we can interfere with the causation, you see. But it's uncaused. It simply is. So keep that in mind. Happiness simply is. And I'll give you an update of what's going on here. It's possible the internet may go out. You see, it's possible. I got this feeling that maybe the internet may go out. Maybe hard to communicate in the future. Hopefully not. Hopefully not. So just give you this heads up. Heads up on late May this weekend. Hopefully everything's perfectly fine. We continue to overcome the continuity problem by recognizing that happiness truly is uncaused. Freedom is uncaused. Truth is uncaused. It is. It just is. All right. So abide in the isness. That's what we need to do. All right. That's it.